Hello, Hofstra fans, and welcome to the W. Mason Coach Report with head men's basketball coach Mike Fairley. Welcome to the show, Mike.
Hi, Stephen. Thanks.
So we'll get right into it. Team is 6-5 overall, 2-2 in the league following the series at Northeastern. Kind of where do you assess your team at right now through four conference games?
You know, Stephen, we've had really good moments. Not enough of those moments. Otherwise, we could be 4-0. And no coach would be happy with 2-2, right? In the country, you know, you want to win all your games. So, you know, I think we've learned a lot about our team. Seen a lot of good things, seen a lot of bad things, and things that, as coaches, that we need to adjust and improve and get better at. So certainly not happy at all about being 2-2, but we wouldn't be happy about being 3-1 either, right? You want to be 4-0. You want to be undefeated. You want to win every game that you play. But just continuing to grow and get better and realizing, you know, where we're at now and where we need to get to by March.
Yeah, and your message to your team and message in the media all along has been playing 40 solid minutes. And you can see that, you know, you're getting there at certain points. And you've had, like, great halves here, great 15-minute stretches there. How do you work your team into getting to those longer stretches of great play?
Yeah, it's really, really hard, Steve, right now. And everybody's going to make a run. You know, I kind of alluded to it on Saturday after our game at Northeastern of, you know, the way that we started the second half there was unbelievable and just impossible to sustain. You know, like, you're not going to play that way for 40 minutes. But I think what we really need to get to is getting away from having some of these lulls. On the defensive side, it's when do we lose energy for several possessions in a row, and we're not playing as hard, we're not being as active as we need to be in those situations. So an example of that would be like the second half of the Northeastern game here. You know, we got off to that lead, and did we take our foot off the pedal? Did we, you know, just relax a little bit too much and didn't work the way that we needed to on the defensive end? So, you know, I think that's, you know, a 50-50 proposition. You know, the coach has got to keep coaching and all that stuff, you know, and the guys have to realize, like, hey, when this happens, we got to pick up our own energy too, you know, so that's all on all of us. And then on the offensive side, when we have those lulls, that's on me. That's, you know, how can you get an easy shot? How can you get a layup? How can you get out in transition and get an easy one when you're struggling to score, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 possessions in a row? Look, you're going to miss shots, right? And you're going to have games where you make shots, games where you don't make shots. But when you're not, how do you get an easy one to maybe get some momentum back, or at least to kind of stem the tides of the run that you're in the midst of?
And, you know, January and February are times when teams perfect themselves to get ready for March, and we're no different and been no different for as long as you guys have been here. So taking the positives out of last weekend, have you guys watched the film and been able to see what went so well Thursday in the first half and Saturday in the beginning of the second half that you can kind of build on?
Yeah, so I think the Thursday wrap-up is obviously, you know, our best half of the year followed by the worst half of the year. But I you know, we've addressed and talked about the energy already in the second half, especially defensively. I think the one part about that game was we kind of looked dead, and we were down 5, and we came back, and we had the ball with a chance to win at the end of regulation after, you know, blowing that whole lead, giving up the lead. You know, so I think that showed a lot of character and a lot of heart and what this team is capable of responding to. So I thought that was an impressive takeaway from there. And then Saturday, look, we didn't shoot the ball well in the first half. You know, I think if you go in that game, you say, hey, Northeastern's going to have 30 points at halftime. You say, okay, we're probably in good shape. And we were down 9, you know, so we just didn't make shots. But you're going to have games where you don't. And they're a very good defensive team as well. So we certainly give them credit. Had a great start of the second half, played amazing, got out to a great run, let them come back a little bit. You know, the Walker gets hot, makes some shots, and puts them in a good stretch. And again, like, it just got down the stretch where maybe we weren't getting the greatest shots in the world. And again, that comes back to me and how do we learn to down the stretch when we need to execute, how do we execute, where are we going when we need to get a bucket there. But a lot to learn, and I think we did, and we've reviewed the film with the team and with each other and have had some really good talks the last couple of days about how we need to improve and how we're going to get there.
Absolutely. So before we get to this weekend's opponent, Delaware, let's touch on, you know, there's some news recently from the pro ranks as Eli Pemberton and Justin Wright Foreman have taken the next steps. Eli Pemberton will be a member of the Santa Cruz Warriors, and Justin Wright Foreman will be a member of the Erie BayHawks. Your thoughts on these two guys getting their opportunities in the G League now?
Yeah, it's amazing, and certainly so happy for them, and to see their growth and what they've been able to accomplish and where they've come from. You know, Justin not playing as a freshman, obviously all his accomplishments, and you know, putting himself in a position this way, and Elijah and the way that he improved over the course of 4 years to becoming the player and the person that both of those guys became. So to get their opportunities there are amazing, you know, and man, professional basketball is it's such a unique and difficult thing to navigate, because it's so much about opportunity and, you know, do you find the right team? You know, if Justin was on the Knicks last year instead of the Jazz, he might be in the NBA right now as a full-time player, you know, but there wasn't an opportunity as much with the Jazz. So you just hope that these guys, and they're continuing to work. They're two of the hardest working guys we've ever been around. They've been great. And you just hope they get an opportunity, you know. So now they're in with good franchises that are headed in the right direction. They'll get to showcase their talents here in this G League bubble that's coming up, which is amazing. And, you know, hopefully they do get a shot. Hopefully they do get an opportunity. But at a minimum, it's a great starting point, especially for Elijah being his first year to get in a position like that. And hopefully they get a little bit of an opportunity. And when that door opens a little bit, kick it down and take full advantage of it.
Absolutely. And now on to Delaware, your opponent this week. Give us what kind of challenges does the Delaware team possess for your team this year?
You know, another very, very familiar team. We faced them 6 times in the last 2 years, just like we faced Northeastern 6 times in the last 2 years. So the familiarity and we know each other very, very well. They've had a lot of changeover like we have. You know, they lost their 2 best guys. We lost our 2 best guys. So certainly different teams than last year, guys in different roles, et cetera. And they're still kind of in a place of figuring things out, similar to what we are. You know, they have some really good guards. Anderson and Allen are two highly talented guards. Anderson's a versatile big point guard that can do a little bit of everything. And Ryan Allen is just a fearless scorer who's gotten better at making plays and can really make shots. And then you go down low and you got Dylan Painter down there, and the matchup between Painter and Isaac, it should be a fun one. Two of the better big guys in our conference. You know, he's certainly very, very experienced, Villanova transfer, all that stuff, very physical down low, plays really hard, one of the best offensive rebounders we played against. So those 3 guys, talent-wise, are really, really good, and Coach Inglesby does a great job, always has those guys prepared. Very, very solid defensively, well-schooled, principals are great on that end of the floor. You know, and then obviously the challenge is about, you know, what do they do against our zone?
Well, Mike, we thank you for your time again today, and we wish you good luck this weekend.
Thank you, Stephen.
And thank you, Hofstra fans, for joining us on the W. Mason Coach Report with head men's basketball coach Mike Fairley.